Hello, welcome on the Alt Control series. Tatiana here. I'm a French game designer and artist. I make alternative controller games and playful installations. Today I'm going to tell you how alternative game interfaces are made. If you don't know what I'm talking about, watch the first video of this series. There are as many ways to make alternative game controllers as there are game controllers. Some are made by hacking standard gamepads, like Shooting in the Rain. This alternative controller was made to play at Duck Hunt on the NES, the 8-bit Nintendo's console from the 80s. It was made by hacking the Zappa gun of the console and an umbrella. Others are made from scratch, like Dobotan, and involve mechanical and electronic engineering. But every electronic game shares a common principle. Like any human-machine interaction, alternative controller video games feature a user using a controller to send inputs to a machine. The machine will run a program and send outputs to the user. Some playful installations, like Shooting in the Rain, will change the controller of an already existing video game. Some will add an output to an existing game, like Leg Shocker, a device that pounds players' shins when they get tackled in the soccer game FIFA. But the vast majority of designers will develop a whole new game for their playful installation and run it on a standard computer, like Zombie Crawler. Finally, some will even remove the computer and screen and make a fully electronic installation like Lion Wobbler. But whether a game is based on an alternative input or output, this magic is always made possible by using special printed circuit boards. There are three main types of PCBs used for Alt Control: nanocomputers, microcontrollers, and keyboard encoders. Nanocomputers are small computers about the size of a credit card. These are single-board computers on which you can add components to make special inputs and outputs depending on your needs. It's basically the technology you find in a smartphone. The most famous ones are the Raspberry Pi and the Banana Pi. An example of playful installation using a Raspberry Pi is Extra Reality Codebreaker. Similarly to nanocomputers, microcontrollers feature a CPU, memory, and programmable inputs and outputs, but they are way less sophisticated. They are also usually cheaper. The most famous ones are Arduino boards and Tintis. This is what we used in Atsuno. Finally, keyboard encoders are the simplest to use and cheapest of all. These PCBs only turn electric inputs into keyboard inputs understandable by your computer. You cannot use these boards to run a program, and very few of them will allow you to program outputs. The most famous ones are Makey Makeys and off-brand boards you find in arcade kits. This is what's used in Rainbow Race. Prices of these different technologies vary from 10 to 80 euros. The main difference is that some of them are way easier to use than others. Nanocomputers require way more skills in programming and electronics than keyboard encoders, but of course they also offer way more possibilities. If it's your first experience with alternative controllers, I highly recommend you to start with a keyboard encoder. You'll find arcade kits online for about 20 euros. Inside you'll usually find 10 push buttons, a joystick, a keyboard encoder, a PCB, and a bunch of cables. It's very easy to plug. Once everything is plugged, you can use a keyboard encoder software. You'll find some online for free, like Joy2Key for Windows and Enjoy2 for Mac. These softwares will allow you to attribute keys to your buttons. And that's all, now you're ready to play games with your controller. If your budget allows it, you can use a Makey Makey to make a controller. You won't even need a software for this board, just plug the cables and play with it. It will automatically send keyboard inputs to the computer. The keys are indicated on the board. What's nice with the Makey Makey is that it works with anything electrically conductive, from bananas and wine to non-Newtonian fluids. If you'd prefer to use sensors, actuators, and sophisticated outputs, you can use other technologies like Little Bits. Or if you feel reckless, you can buy Arduino starter kits with lots of electronic components. As I said, there are many ways to make alternative game interfaces. I've made games based on MIDI controllers, and I'm currently working with audio signal. If you'd like me to get into the technical details of Alt Control games, or if you'd prefer more design-oriented content in the next video, let me know in the comment or somewhere else online. Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time, take care and be playful!
J'en suis fière, ok?
Non, mais c'est certes.
Tu sais combien de temps ça m'a pris à faire cette merde? Beaucoup trop de temps.